So taking an example D, as we know that number of total number of customer who are going to buy the computer or not, I have the data analysis, the result of this by a number of customer who buys the computer or not, I have the total numbers as 14. I have number of yes as 9 and number of no's as 5. That we already done, right? So 9 and 5, we know that. So 9 plus 5 is 14 also, we know that value. So that let us see. So Genie of day, D is very easy to evaluate. What is the equation I have? 1 minus algebraic sum of P square J for J equal to 1 to N. So I have number two classes here, one with respect to number of yes and one with respect to number of no's. So let us see. So I will take number of yes as 9. So 1 minus in place of P square, the ratio 9 by 14 square whole square is due to number of yes minus 5 by 14 is due to number of no's here. So do this. Substitute, you get the answer as 0.49, 0.459. Please cross verify later. Then next step, what was that equation I have? Gini A of T should be D1 by D, Gini of D1 and mod D2 by D, Gini of D2. So let us see which parameter we are going to do. So many parameters we can consider here. So since I have taken income here in the previous example, I will continue the income only. So I'll take an example of Gini of income. When you talk about Gini of income, I want to partition the income into two categories, students. So what is that I have taken in this example? No? Initially, I have taken an example as how many categories you have, low, medium, and high. So what is it I am trying to do? No? D1 I am taking with respect to low and medium. D2 I am taking with respect to high. So how is it I am going to split? Let us see. Yeah. So coming to income. We already analyzed. We know that 4 high is there, 6 medium is there, low 4 lows are there. So now I'll take low and medium together as one partition, say D1, and I'll take D2 as a second partition with respect to high. So number of mediums, how much? 6 plus number of lows, 4. 6 plus 4 is how much? 10. So what is number of highs here? 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of highs is 4. Correct, no, students? So out of 14, I've taken D1 and D2 as two groups. In that, D1 is due to what? Low and medium. 6 plus 4, 10 I am taking. D2 is about high, the partition 2. How many high I have? 4 I have. So how is it I am going to redefine the equation here with respect to D1 and D2. So Gini A of D, how is it you are going to write? D mod D1 by D into Gini of D1 plus D2 by mod D into Gini of D2. So I'll replace that in place of D1 here. What is it I have used? D1 value, I want to go for 10, low plus medium, 10 by 14, Gini of D1. Gini of D1, again, I have to calculate the help of this equation. I'll come back to that. Plus, in the second term, what is that second term? D2 by D. D2, I am taking the value due to high. So D1 is due to low and medium, students. Forget about high now. Concentrate only on low and medium. With respect to low and medium, how many yes and how many no you are supposed to calculate. So I first year high, leave it. From this one, I am going to check. One yes you have, then low also you are supposed to consider. Medium and low I am taking together. So medium, one yes I have, low one yes, second one I got yes, then leave it. Third one yes is here with respect to low, then leave it. Fourth one yes with respect to low, fifth one yes with respect to medium, then six, seven I have, high you leave it, that's all. Seven yes, together low and medium I have seven yes. Same I calculate, together low and medium how many no's you have? This is yes, you leave it yes. Then low one no I have got. Then medium one no I have got. Two no's I have got. Then yes, yes, yes. Then medium one more no I have. So low and medium together number of no's is 3. So actually 10, I have 10 number of no's and mediums, right? In that I have with respect to low and medium, I have 7 yes and 3 no. Correct, no? So based on that, we'll complete the evaluation now, students. So now, so here, number same way, with respect to this, how you are putting number of yes and number of for overall here. Now, out of 10, I have number of yes 7 and number of no 3 with respect to D1. So substitute that 1 minus in place of yes, I have 7 by 10 whole square minus 3 by 10 whole square for in the number of no's here. So that is the first term, Gini of D1 you want. Same way, let us check for high now for D2. So plus 4 by 14 into 1 minus. So in place of 9 and 5, I have to check for high now. How many number of yes is there in with respect to high and how many number of no's is there with respect to high? Yeah. So high, how many high you have? 1, 2, 3, 4. Check here. High one, no, I have high. 2, no, I have same way. High one, yes, I have. And then one more high, yes, I have. So out of 4, I have 2 no's and 2 yes. Same thing as yesterday. Here, first 2 is due to number of yes, yes. Second 2 is due to number of no's, yes. So 1 minus 2 by 4 whole square minus 2 by 4 whole square. Yes. To substitute, you get the answer as 0.443. So this is the answer for Gini of income for low and medium as D1 with respect to low second part D2 as high. So this is one of the parameter you have got. The answer is 0.443. Same way. Now you cannot ask question that why you have taken low medium as D1 and high as D2. You can take your own example. See here, you can go for in place of low and medium, you can even go for low high as D1 and D2 as medium. Same way you can go for D1 as medium and high and D2 as low. So you may get a different results. It may be a small difference, that's it. For the category 1, you have got the answer as 0.443. For D1 low, medium and D2 high. Same way for D1 low, high and D2 medium, you have got the you will get the answer as 0.458. Same way if you go for D1 as medium and high and D2 as low, then you get